Let's see. Here we are at the end of May, and the pace of viewer releases has been picking up. So here, perhaps you can perhaps you can give us a look ahead here.
Sure. So let's see. The next viewer that we're likely to be promoting is FMod Studio. With the audio improvements, that is, we just put out an RC update for that today. But as far as we know, everything's looking good there. So as soon as we have enough test hours against the RC update, we'll be probably promoting that sometime next week. You know, subject to the usual disclaimers about unexpected problems coming up. Other viewers that we have in the pipeline getting fairly close to promotion would include Love Me Render. That's got some graphics changes in it. We have a couple of high priority graphics fixes that we think are ready to go but that don't have a home yet. These are both things that came in with EAP. One of them was like a sort of a shiny plastic look for rigged meshes. We are definitely planning to fix that. I know people have expressed some concern about it. But I'm not sure which viewer that's going to turn up in. It could wind up in Love Me Render. It could wind up in Main. You know, once that's actually out. Let's see. Other stuff we have in the pipeline. There's a CEF update viewer that's pretty similar to the viewer that was used for the Adult Swim. It's got a new build of the Chrome embedded framework and has support for YouTube live streaming. It doesn't support every service out there. It's gonna vary depending on the particular details of the service, but it should at least have a bit more support for recent web than used to. Let's see what else is going on. Project viewers, we've got legacy profiles, which I think is close, but there was still a question of whether there's maybe one more web change needed there, so we're trying to get that one sorted out. And the copy paste viewer has some build tool improvements. That has that's going through another round of UI updates, but should be hopefully getting close to coming out as an RC. And I think that should be the case for the Meshel Bloater project viewer as well. Should be a good candidate for getting into RC fairly soon. Let's see. I think those are the big ones. We've got the usual mate pipeline work going on. Next mate viewer will be ARAC, but I'm not sure exactly where that's going to fit in the RC and promotion schedule. That's not actually an RC yet, but it should be coming out much longer. Let's see. Question.
And tools update is in QA for again.
Yeah. Tools update. We've got there were two remaining issues that I think Nat has. Believes he's found fixes for this week, so we'll be getting that out as soon as we can.
That went to QA yesterday, but it has not finished yet. So yeah. we're hoping that by next week it'll be it will have gotten through QA and we can put that in RC as well.
I'm surprised we don't actually have that one out as a project viewer.
Our assumption was that not very many people would pick it up.
That's possible.
But for those of you who have been wishing you could compile with newer tools, I want you to know that's still out there, and we're hoping. So We'll see if we can get that through the QA cycle. If not, it may take a while, but we'll see. Cool. And let's see. Other stuff. There are not any big system changes on the simulator side in the works. We are looking at, but we have some fixes to some bugs that have shown up that are working their way through the pipeline. Is Ryder here?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, there you are. You're so quiet. You're down at the bottom of my list.
I'm all sneaky.
Yeah. Yeah, you got any look ahead on the next couple of simulator updates?
So probably the next one in the pipeline will be Voices Carry, which is the extended chat range. And that will be hopefully hitting RC not next week, but the week following. There is a maint that is still taking shape that should follow the following week.
Right. And to clarify, because there's been a fairly active forum thread on this, it is our current expectation that the change to chat ranges will only affect channel zero. Is that correct?
That is correct.
All right. So if you've been worrying about whether or not we're going to break what your script does on its private chat channel with some other thing or with dialogues, it just won't change. Whatever it was, it was. It will continue to be. This is just for channel zero, local chat, the one that we all see in the dialogue boxes that people spend so much time and energy arguing over the relative utility of. Ryder, you should drop a note into that forum thread about that too.
I will do so.
People are getting very energetic and it's sort of wandered off onto another whole debate, of course, because that's what happens in forum threads.
Oh dear.
I wanted to make sure that we clarified that. Let's see. I don't think we have any other news on the technology front. So I guess the floor is open. A wider range of encodings and codecs and so forth, and that is our intent. We thought it would be good to get this version that has this service working out there. It also, of course, since it's an update to a much newer version of the Chrome embedded framework, it includes all the patches and security fixes that come with staying current, which is a good thing. Beck, I don't think we have seen that particular one. but it can be a little challenging to debug what's going on inside the Bugsplat connectors. On the other hand, we've found that the support people are pretty good. So, so is Firestorm going to put out an EAP beta soon? Yeah, indeed. Totally fair.
That one hasn't been fixed. It's being looked at.
Kitty, does that repro on our viewer?
Oh, I mean, we have had some discussion about the undies, but I hadn't heard that there was a general order issue.
Yes, we decided to take that off. It was well, there were a number of ways around the intent, so it was pointless. That was one of those artifacts of the past that nobody had ever gotten around to getting rid of. We decided it was time. We have seen issues with two monitors, mostly having to do with resolution changes, but Okay, folks. Thank you all for coming. We'll see you next time.